हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ उमेश अरोड़ा फ्रॉम कैटकैम सॉल्यूशन मेरठ एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट टूल पाथ फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ पार्ट। आई हैव दिस पार्ट ओके एंड द बॉटम सरफेस ऑफ दिस इज ऑल्सो ए प्लानर, सो आई विल यूज सम प्लानर ऑप्शन फॉर दिस पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड सम टूल पाथ एंड आई विल रिपीट दिस फॉर यू। So first I have done here is this my face milling. After that I have used for finish wall to finish the walls, and after that I have used this finish floor, it will finish the floor, and at the last the material which is left over the corners I have used this cleanup corner. With the help of this cleanup corner we can remove the excess material which is left over the corners. So here I have used two tools. This one is my tool, you can see here it's 8 millimeter diameter tool, and second is 2 millimeter diameter. I have retrieved this tool from the library and I will tell you how to retrieve the tool from the library. So start, take away MCS mill, and I will create a new workpiece for my tool path. So define, this is my workpiece part, and blank, for blank I am taking this bounding block so it will cover it properly. And okay, so my workpiece is defined, and for tool just go to create and you can retrieve tool from the library from this option. And here if you want to add anvil, click here and OK. And all the tools which are available here in the library, you can see here, you can choose any one of this as per your requirement. So I will use this and this two for my operation, this two and one. So click over this workpiece, and here we will change it to mill planner, and mill planner I will use this floor and wall for my roughing operation. And tool is 8 millimeter diameter tool, workpiece is workpiece one, and I am doing roughing operation. So select, this is my cutting area, select the cut area, which area you want to cut, and wall, no need to select this wall, automatically it will detect. So click here, automatic wall, and rough cut region containment floor, it will follow as per the floor, and cut pattern change it to fall apart according to the part shape the tool path will generate. And here depth of cut, just take it one and let's generate this. It will generate. So I don't know what is the depth of this part, so let's measure this distance. Just zoom this, and 15 is the height of my part, so double click and change the blank to 15 and again generate this. The tool path will generate for the 15 millimeter depth, and click OK. And if you want to see the preview, 3D dynamic preview, you can select and play 2D dynamic. So the tool path will come like this. And meanwhile, if you are new to our channel, please do subscribe our channel. Okay, so this is finishing operation, first operation is done, click OK. And so here in cutting parameter we will go, and in stock you can see the stock is, if you want to left the stock is left at the walls only, walls here is the walls, and I am taking this one. And for floor also take this one, so that some stock will remain for finish wall and finish floor operation. Okay, I am generating this again. Now replay. See, now material is left 1 millimeter over the wall and 1 millimeter over this floor. So with next operation we will finish this wall and floor. Next go to operation, and here first I will choose this finish wall. With the help of this finish wall we will finish our walls, and my tool is same 8 millimeter anvil, and change it to finish and click OK. Now part boundary, select the part boundaries and blank boundary. So first I will choose part boundary and use this curve method, and here in curve we have to change it to tangent curve, so that it will select all the tangent curve in single click. Now tool side is outside, but I want this inside because my wall is inside the curve, that's why, and click OK. Now specify blank boundary. So we have to define the blank. For this operation I have to finish only inside this pocket. Okay, I want to finish the walls inside this pocket, that's why I'm selecting this inside face and click OK. So part and blank boundaries are defined. Still one thing is needed, that this is specified floor. So my last floor wall is this. This is my floor. So click OK. So tool will cut up to this floor. That's why we have to define this. Now automatically this cut pattern is profile, because tool will move according to the profile of this floor, of this blank geometry or part boundary. If you need any extra pass, that time you have to change this, otherwise just define this tool will finish the walls and click here. Now see, just reduce this speed. Okay, so wall will finish, click OK. Okay, next operation is this finish floor. If you want to finish the floor, if material is left over the floor, that time you will use this the same, and here the part boundary, the same method what I have used last time, same method I will apply this time, and the tool side is inside. Okay, and blank, my blank is this, click OK. And specify floor is this. Okay, and the rest is same, just generate this. See here, and generate and 3D dynamic, you can see. Okay, just finish this. Only some material is left over the corners here, you can see on the corners some material is left, and I want to remove this material from the corners. That time I have to create new tool, and my tool is this. This is smaller tool, so that it will cut on the corners. For this time I will use this cleanup corner will clean the material which is left after the last operation. It will clean that tool, that material. And here we have to select this 2 millimeter tool and click OK. Next select part boundary, part boundary is this tool inside, OK, and blank boundary is this face, because I want to cut inside this portion. OK, so this time this whole part is not my blank, only inside portion was blank. And specify floor, this is my floor, and rest is same, just go to cutting parameter, and here in containment I will use blank as a use reference tool. So tool will use the current tool will use previous tool as a reference, and the material which is left after cutting of this 8mm tool, material which is left after cutting this 8mm tool, it will cut. And generate, it will generate. Now in cut level, change this to the, you can define depth of cut and say 1mm is the depth of cut. Now generate and tool will cut rest of the material with 1mm depth. Okay, and tool is cutting according to the level, so just stop this and we will change in cutting parameter and in strategy the cut order is depth based. Okay, so it will cut first depth, then it will move to another depth and see. So it is cutting first step, then it will move to next part, next corner. So hope you understand this all operation properly. If you have any query regarding this, you can message me, comment me. Or thank you for watching and keep subscribing our channel.